إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُم مُّصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَّبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ صدق الله العظيم. Today, inshallah, the subject of my khutbah is what the condition of the world is today. And inshallah, I will submit five different approaches that how we can really handle the situation we have all around the world today. And we know for now, last many months, that humanity is really suffering. People are going through a lot of misery and pain. And it has become really a difficult time for majority of the people all around the world. And inshallah, today I'm going to share some practical things that what we can do, especially as a Muslim. The very first thing, we have to understand the right perspective. We have to make sure that our paradigm of understanding of this world and the life of this world is correct. The ayah of Surah Baqarah, which I read in front of you, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that this is the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests people, that He sends down the factor of fear, the factor of famine, the factor of loss of life, property, and crops. So this is the way Allah sometimes tests humanity, individually or collectively. And this is the way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides some people opportunities to act properly so they could be upgraded in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So their muqamat will be raised, their status will be raised. And this is opportunity for many people, so they get rid of their sins also. So nothing can happen in this world without the knowledge and information and will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our iman. And the good thing is that if we really take the right approach, there are three benefits. The very first benefit is that I will get the reward if I will show patience. And the second benefit is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the opportunities He has provided me, I will be able to take advantage from those opportunities. My brothers and my sisters. And the third very important thing which can happen, if I show patience and I am the one who is learning, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for me to go through that hardship and difficulty. Because if I complain, if I make noise, why me? Why is it happening? Where is Allah? The negative is that I lose patience, so I lose my reward. Number two, by complaining, whatever is happening is not going to go away. Rather, it's going to become more intense and more aggressive against me. And it will be more difficult for me to pass and face that challenge, my brothers. And then end of the day, there will be no reward for me. So this perspective, just keep in mind, my brothers and my sisters. The very first thing as a remedy I want to present to you is, you know, as a doctor, this is my job first to teach you how to diagnose the problem. Until unless we will know the problem, we cannot cure, we cannot treat. The number one problem that humanity has done in general, you know, we have some responsibility individually as a human being, and we have some responsibility as a ummah, as a nation, as a society, as humanity. The biggest mistake we have done in the past many centuries is that we have lost the direction of life. We have lost the dignity of the purpose of life. We have lost even sensitivity about the well-being of each other. Whatever happens to somebody else is not my business, is not my headache. That is the approach. In last 100, 200 years, what we have witnessed all around the world, either it's Syria or Palestine or Iraq or Afghanistan or Burma or Yemen, or even to the extent our own Muslim countries. And I will say this to you, my brothers and my sisters, that Islam, as a preacher of Islam, all humans are equal in our eyes. I should be as concerned, rather I should be more concerned, if any non-Muslim gets suffered in the country where Muslims are in majority. We have seen with our own eyes what happens sometime in Pakistan, or many majority Muslim countries. You know, Prophet ﷺ in Medina says, if I get opportunity to have treaty like Hilful Fudul, I will go for such treaty again. And these are the words of Prophet ﷺ in Medina. And Hilful Fudul was for the protection of human beings regardless of their religion. Because every human being is valuable regardless of his faith, regardless of his country or color. My brothers, how many times you and me, we woke up middle of the night and we have raised our hands for our brothers and sisters in Syria, our brothers and sisters in Kashmir. How many times that I have shed any tears for my brothers suffering all around the world? How many times that if there was injustice in my family, I was able to raise my voice? You know, silence is not an option as a Muslim. Silence is not an option. If there is injustice in my own family, then I should be the one raising voice against it. If any injustice is happening in my society, I will be the one should be raising voice against it. So how many times that I have fulfilled that responsibility, my brothers and my sisters, this is really is one of the major problems. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in whatever capacity, has given you and me power. Most of us have acted like a pharaoh. We complain about the country president and prime minister, and they are misusing their power. What about me? When Allah has made me qawwam of my home, head of my home, how I have behaved in my home? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made me boss at my business, what was my behavior? But if you and me critically do analysis of our behaviors, our attitudes, wallahi, most of us, men or women, we act like a pharaoh. And I can tell you one thing, that if people are tired of your behavior, of your attitude, of your approach, that means in your heart you have not developed yet khashiya, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the person who really truly has khashiya, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sense of accountability that one day he will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inni zanantu anni mulaqin hisabiya, then that person, whenever he will say anything, whenever he will do anything, he will make sure that he will not transgress, he will not cross his boundaries to hurt the feelings of any fellow being. My brothers, from this perspective, we have to repent. We have to make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about our insensitivity, about our approach and attitude, that how we have kept silent when there was humanity suffering close to me or far away from me. And as I said, silence is not an option. So we have to make tawbah. And tawbah is going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawbah is that I repent, I commit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in future I am not going to repeat the mistake I have done in past, Ya Rabbul Alameen. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you and me the tawfiq that we do tawbah-e-kamila, the pure and sincere tawbah. Because it is said to have shifa-e-kamila, to have complete cure of the problem, you have to do tawbah which is complete. And complete tawbah is that I sincerely return and I commit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will not go on that path again. The second thing which I want to say here, you know, let's evaluate our station of shukr. How many of us are real among shakirin? How many of us show attitude of gratitude? You know, there is a hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I really never understood that hadith that much like I did in last 6, 7, 8 months, in which Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that if you wake up in the morning and you have your health and you have peace all around you, that you can go out and do whatever you want to do, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you sustenance of that day. Health, peace around you. Peace means you can go out. So you have no fear of any virus or any enemy army or anybody. And the third thing, Allah has given you sustenance, risk of that day. It is like that Allah has presented the bounties of all universe in front of you. How many of us, we wake up in the morning and we feel safe? Challenges of health, challenges of peace. And many of us are really having challenges of sustenance, the risk as well. And the second hadith of Prophet ﷺ, the two most neglected bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we ignore the most, one is health and the other one is free time. That when Allah had given us opportunities that we could have come to masjid, we could have gone for umrah and hajj, we could have traveled back home or even here in the country to help out people, to help out humanity. But we all ignored that health Allah had given us. We all ignored the bounty of free time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and me. My brothers and my sisters, I suggest make a list of all the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has showered upon you and me. And be thankful, because thankfulness, the gratitude and patience, they both go hand in hand. The person who is doing shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is actually showing patience in whatever condition he goes through. You know the difference between Waliullah and a common person is, for Waliullah, the station of sabr is a station of shukr. that he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, whatever condition you have kept me, I am thankful to you. It could have been worse. And thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a trial of my dunya. This is not a trial of my iman. What if this was a trial of my iman and if I had failed, I would have doomed myself. Ya Allah, this is thank to you that this whatever is happening around me, it could have been worse. And this is just a test of my dunya, not a test of my iman. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gives you and me tawfiq, not just doing a lip service of shukr. Rather, we are living a life of gratitude, living a life of shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best way of shukr is that whatever bounties Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and me, we use those bounties in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We return back, we pay back, we use all those bounties to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I am thankful to you, and the best use of these bounties is using in your path. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gives you me tawfiq, that we really can understand the situation and we can have a good response, not reaction, response to the situation. Response is calculated, well measured, well thought. Response is not a reaction. Reaction is something abrupt. So as a Muslim, we should learn how to respond, not to react. The third thing which I would like to share with you, my brothers and sisters, you know, in this difficult time, first thing I said that we should have a right perspective, the right paradigm of life. Because life is always full of trial. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ That I have created humanity in constant struggle. Struggle from birth up until the last breath. So we should understand the purpose of all these trials and tribulations and calamities we go through. And the second I say that we should try to keep ourselves in the station of shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Third thing I will say, brothers, that how we can really feel sakina, sukoon, tranquility, peace in our hearts in the time we are living through. You know, sukoon and sakina is something internal. Something internal that you feel internally. And people who have even lived in the worst time of their life because they had some higher goal in life and right perspective of their life, even on those difficult days, they were able to stay happy, my brothers and my sisters. You know the difference between a child and grown-up is, child lives and enjoys the moment he lives in. हमारे उर्दू में कहते हैं ना लम्हा मौजूद. The child is not worried about his past. He has no remorse. He has no regret. He has no guilt about his past. And he has no fear of speculations about the future. He lives in the moment he is passing through, he is going through. This is the major difference between us as a grown-up and a child. We as a human being, we either live in our past, guilt feeling, remorse, regret, or we are worried about what will happen in future. So whatever bounties Allah has given us, we are not even able to enjoy those bounties, my brothers and my sisters. Let me also clarify one thing. You know, speculations we do about future, you know, the insurance people, how they sell their insurance to you by creating a fear. Oh, this will happen, that will happen. You know, speculations. And you and me, it's not me saying this. This is a data. 95% of speculations never come true. 95%. So as a Muslim, I should be fear-free when it comes to the fear factor about the future, about speculations about my future. I rather enjoy the bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me. You know, in sukoon is in tawakkal on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sukoon is in qana'at, containment, that whatever Allah has given me, I am happy. The way He wants me to live, I am happy about it. Sukoon is in patience. Sukoon is when you help somebody. Sukoon is that when you forgive people. Sukoon is when you are thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and people. And sukoon is when you are in zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I also want to clarify one more thing here. You know, a lot of time our conception is that if Allah has, you know, forbidden this thing, this is haram, this is haram, this is haram, don't do this, don't do that. And most of the time, those hudud, those boundaries set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we take those boundaries with negative connotation. We feel like, you know, we want to free ourselves from these shackles of religion. And you know, let me just give you a little touch. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids something, that is to take you for a real freedom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like when you are going towards your bedroom, and many things which are allowed to you, you leave those things, you know, behind until you reach to your bedroom and you close your door. How free you feel in that room. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to take you and me in His haram. Haram is the secure, sacred place. Place where you can get sakina, baytul haram. Kaaba is baytul haram. That haram is not with negative connotation, is with positive connotation. That whatever boundaries Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set for me, alcohol or gambling or interest or fornication, those are the real shackles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you and me to get freedom, so that you can come in the haram of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the umbrella of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have the true freedom. Rabi bin Amir, in the castle of Rustam, said Islam came to free us from all the false gods and to give us in the guidance and khudai of one God, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and my sisters, I will say one thing and close. You know, this time we are going through, this is a time of sharing and caring. And I will say to you, especially white collar people, they are really going through difficult time here and back home. But our responsibility first is to take care of things here in our neighborhood, in our community. And if we fulfill our responsibility here, then we expand, you know, our area of concern. But first we have to find brothers and sisters in our area. Wallahi, this is the time, this is the opportunity for you and me to shine. This is the opportunity for you and me to raise. This is the opportunity for you and me for dawah. And dawah not only to non-Muslims, even to our Muslim brothers and sisters. That you and me show this attitude of caring. We call brothers and sisters. They don't always need some financial support from you and me. Most of the time, they just need some emotional support. So stay in touch with each other here and back home, and try to keep checking on brothers and sisters to make sure that we all are safe and okay. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanatan fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina azaban nar. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Rabbi ighfir wa raham wa anta khairur rahimin.
Allahu Akbar.